I've got a great affinity to and love for country and country music in Nashville. And
well, it all started in your homeland, so thank y'all for that.
Yeah, Ireland and Scotland kind of kicked it all off, mm-hmm. So yeah, it's in the blood, the old country.
Well, I thought it was a cool connection that we had. You know, I sang country music, and country music pretty much started in Ireland and Scotland. When the Irish and the Scottish came over, those songs evolved in the Appalachian Mountains, all the way from up into Canada, all the way down into the South, and it just kept moving west into Tennessee and all over the United States. And thank you, Irish and the Scottish people.
Hello.
Ladies.
Hi.
Look who I've got.
Oh my God.
I'm a huge country music fan. I love country music. It's something that I connected to pretty easily. Being from Ireland, I didn't realize how connected Irish traditional music and country music are. And the more time I've spent in America touring the States, spending time in the South, I've realized how much I love country music. And some of my favorite singers, especially on the female side, no offense, Blake, have been country music stars.
This is the raddest Mega Mentor we've ever had.
Oh,
amazing.
What's cool about country music right now, there's so many paths going on. And one of those paths are people like almost doing the throwback sound.
I feel like country music is interesting, like where it was whenever I was a kid and then even growing up with it. And then it kind of has so many different paths now. Blake and I always talk about that.
It does.
Some of the new artists are coming out, they're having that throwback sound, mm-hmm. which I love.
Oh, everybody loves that.
Yeah.
What the 90s was to country music, I think everybody's craving that and wanting it again.
Girl, the 90s of country music! It was so good.
Kelly told me all about you.
Kelly told, what did she say?
She said she loves you.
Oh, I love Kelly. Even though I don't come from a country background, I have a high respect for country music and country artists and artists that are able to build strongholds in the industry of being the top tier artist for so long. So you living in Nashville currently?
Yeah.
Were you raised there or you
Oklahoma.
Moved there when you were there? Okay, my great grandmother's from Tulsa, but I've never made it there. Reba has that knowledge and insight that not only my team, but myself can learn from.
Are y'all both from Oklahoma?
Yep. Same part, like literally the next county over is where she was born and raised. And I know people who knew Reba before she was Reba, and she made it so it was like, man, this can really happen.
You know, Reba was the person that I looked to the most as I was trying to make it in country music. It gave me that little extra boost of hope that, man, somebody from a small town in the middle of nowhere can make it. Look, Reba did it, and it really was something that was a driving force for me.
I'm wondering if the first time I ever met you was when you guys did the grand opening of the Starstruck building.
That was 96 is when we built it.
I may have shook your hand.
I remember it vividly.